Hello everyone, good morning, I'm Varun. Through this demo or video, I would like to show how to generate a Microsoft XML from input XML using a Java map through SAP PI PO as a middleware. Now this was my end-to-end scenario wherein SAP sends a message type which of proxy message type to SAP PI PO, and SAP PI PO has to generate Excel file in the third party system through file. So through FTP adapter, it has to place a Microsoft Excel file. Just want to give a heads up that this particular conversion, that is a proxy to Excel file, can be done in two ways. One is through Java map and another is through Excel map. Whichever you are comfortable, you can one can proceed with that particular approach. In this demo, I am showing through a Java map. Okay, that's about my introduction. Now, what is the input payload? This is my input payload. The message type has orders, and this orders can repeat, and each orders will have a item segment. So for each item, I have to create a line in Excel file. How will be my output? So this is my output. This is the row serial number which I will hard code, and these are the data in this row 1, 2, delivery date are from this particular payload. So whatever I get these values in the payload, I'm populating into Excel sheet, and at last I'm giving the, because there are two items in this particular Excel sheet, I have to give a sum of all the number of segments present, which is total record equal to 2. All right. That's about the input and the output file. Also, please note that I have written a blog on this around 1 year back. So you can as well check this blog in SAP community. I have written this blog around 1 year back in SAP community. Now the reason for me to come up with a video is that in a blog I cannot clearly explain step by step of the Java code. So through this video I'm trying to explain the Java code in more detail. Also, please note that I've uploaded this Java code in the GitHub. In the GitHub you can find the Java code of this particular scenario. I've already uploaded this in the GitHub. Once you using this URL, you can download the Java code. Okay, that's about the introduction. Now let me open the Java code of this. Sorry, one more thing. Assumption is that people who are watching this video have a good knowledge of SAP and Java mapping. As this falls under a little bit of complex scenario, you should have a good knowledge of Java mapping. All right. If you see this is the name class file, name of the class which I've given. This extends an abstract transformation. Okay, whenever Java map is implemented, that is when it extends abstract transformation, it has to implement the transform method. Transform method will have argument 0 and output argument out. Okay, I'm creating a trace. Normally trace we should keep it when we do the coding in development and UAT to check the output. Once the code is ready, or once you completely develop the code, one has to comment this code. For now I'm not commenting this trace. All right. Okay, Excel file, to generate an Excel file, it will have basically three segments. One is the header. Whenever in an Excel file this particular header is encountered, the Microsoft OS will automatically recognize that this is an Excel sheet and it will open through a Excel file. So this particular header segment is very important. This is where Microsoft or the operating system recognizes that the file is an Excel file. So this is the header which does all the magic. The next is the, in each header we have a table. Under the table we have a row. You remember in the output, I've shown you this first line, serial number, delivery date. These are hard coded. So this is where I'm hard coding the name, serial number, delivery date, delivery number, store code, and etc. So this is where I'm hard coding the column names. All right. After we hard code, the next is to append the data. How do I do that? Using a DOM parser. As one might be aware, an XML file can be parsed using a DOM parser and a SAX parser. DOM parser basically loads the entire payload, iterates through each node, whereas SAX parser goes from each node. It does not load the entire payload. In fact, it goes from each node to the next node. So if one has a payload whose file is very large, then it's not suggestible to go for a DOM parser. If the payload size is very high, then it is suggestible to go for a SAX parser. Also, please note that this is just for info. We cannot blindly always use a DOM parser, or we cannot blindly always use a SAX parser. It depends on the requirement. Sometimes DOM parser is very easy to fulfill the requirement, or sometimes SAX parser is very easy to complete the requirement. How do you get this? Only through experience you get this. So the more you practice, the more you recognize which approach you should go for. In this scenario, I'm going for a DOM parser. The first step is to create an instance of DOM builder. After I create the instance, I create the document builder. Then I create the document to which I pass the input stream. Once I pass the input stream, I get the elements by tag name orders. You remember my payload has a elements called orders. So first I'll read the orders. After I get the orders list, I'll iterate through orders. Then I'll get the items. In the orders, I have items. So for each item, I get the values and then I create a row. So this is the Excel row. In this Excel row, you can see the cell, data, type. How do you want the type to be? It can be string or number. It can be any other type also. In this interface, I had the requirement of string and number. So I went for the string and number. That's it. And last, you append the trailer. You remember we appended that header. Also, you should append the trailer for the Excel to work or to open properly without any errors. So this is how we should build a Java map to create an Excel file. We first build the header, then we build the data for which each data we build a row, then we append the trailer, then we append the trailer. Once the entire payload is ready, we pass it on to the output payload. Then it will generate a Excel file. Hope this video is helpful for the people who are having a similar kind of requirement. Thank you.